XOMC for the intro. This is just a montage of the items that are going to be listed on eBay. This is the Beryl Armstrong one. Pictures are okay, I suppose, but that's the pictures you'll see on the eBay listings. The only one I'm not going to put on is the teapot. That's at the end. Only because I really want to identify that mark, and if any of you out there know about that J. Kent Royal Court wear, that would be helpful. I know it's English, I know it's like where it's from, and there's lots of teapots designed like that, that they have that teapot there. And it's gone through, it's stood the test of time. It's been used up until the, I would say the 70s. So, quite a common teapot, but the decoration and that makes it a little bit special. So, the more information I get about it, the better it would be. That would be helpful. And NAPCO, North American Pottery Cooperative or something like that. That's a little bit interesting. On to the Wembley ware. I probably missed a total thing just rambling about the teapot, but the Wembley ware thing, it's not particularly big. All the dimensions will be listed on the eBay listing, so it's up to you to look at it, I suppose, only if you want it, or perhaps you want to see it. Nice picture of the mark, the stamp. The Port Elliot ware, South Australia. It's that looked alright. The picture came, but shows its true yellowness rather than that bright sort of video colour I ended up getting. But and you know, that's a, you can see it's got 50s written all over it. It's a nice looking thing. It's hard to see the mark because it's overglazed. Tried to get a bit of light reflection on it there, but I just cast a shadow instead. Hey, it's Brownie Downing, or I don't know, it could be anything. Could be, I am pretty convinced it's Brownie Downing, but as there's no mark and I haven't seen one like it, I can't say what. But the maroon lips instead of red, that's usually a thing. The tinker that sits on a turtle, maroon lips. Here's that teapot. Just wanted to be able to show you what it looked like and everything. And it's a common design. Like, there's them with different flower patterns on it and stuff. But this has like a, it's had brown, it's sort of like an older sort of, or it gives you the impression of it being older. All the gold's highlighted, see. The flowers, they were painted afterwards, but that brown and the gold, I think was already on it. So, you know, and they just highlighted it sort of thing. And that's characteristic of like early 1900s and stuff like that, so yeah, and that shroud. I'll call it a shroud because it just sounds wrong. Okay, well, that'll be this video. Enjoy, have a look at eBay, might be worth it. The Beryl Armstrong's a pretty groovy thing, so that looks like a chip, but it's a shadow. There's the mark. And that's probably where it was sitting when it was fired. So, yeah, here we go up to the mark. If you know this mark or if you've seen this mark, can you please message it in the bottom of this video? All right, well, thanks for that, and enjoy.